Hi, welcome to Priscilla's Kitchen. My name is Chef Priscilla Umeda. Today we're going to be making one Nigeria, in fact, Ekpeye tribal soup. It is a peasant soup. Now, a lot of you say you know Nigerian food. You don't know nothing. And like I always promise, stick with me and I will show you the meals that you have never seen on YouTube or anywhere. So let's get to it. Today we're going to be making a soup that I call Melechi. It is a peasant soup from Ekpeye tribe where I come from. It is made with the simplest, cheapest ingredients, but believe me, the proof is in the taste. So let's get cooking. From here, I have jumbo crayfish. This has been smoked. This is exactly how Nigeria smoke their crayfish or shrimp. This is how it goes, but this is a jumbo crayfish. Right here, I have oyster mushrooms. People think that mushrooms are only in Asia. It's a lie. We have lots of variety. And as you can see, it's very tender, fresh. This we add to the last minute of the cooking. And all we do is we take off the, here, we cut off the ends. That's how that is made. I'm not even going to chop it up. I'm going to put it in the soup like this. As you always know, Nigeria like heat. This here is scotch bonnet, yellow orange scotch bonnet. Then the star to this soup is what we call Ikpalapkala in my language. Now don't sweat it, this is bony fish. I'm not going to be flaking nothing else out of this fish. I've taken out the guts. That's all you need to worry, because every part of this fish is the seasoning and what gives this soup the uniqueness that we're going to see. Of course, my co-bouillon is null cube. A lot of people ask me, why do you always use just null cube? Hey, I live outside Nigeria. Besides, I love the taste of null cube. Now, if I have access to more, I'm going to be using different variety. Then here, I have snails. Now, I purposely left this half washed. As you can see, it has been shelled and somewhat washed. What we do is, you have two options to making this very crunchy. You can use lime juice or you can use salt. And then I will squeeze and squeeze and squeeze and wash until it gets very tough and rinse it. Then you'll be ready to go to the soup. Here, this is another star ingredient of this soup. This is what we call kanda. This is a cow skin that has been burnt. This is the cut that is closer to the head. So as you can see, it's thicker. All I've done is giving it a good dice to a bite-sized portion. And of course, the thickening agent to this soup will be what I call edebuji osa. Remember, this is an Ekpeye soup. I would have to give you the names that I know that is Ekpeye language. This is edebuji osa. It's melanga white. And is the thickening agent for this. A little goes a long way. Of course, it won't be Nigerian soup without palm oil. This is what we share virtually in every tribe in Nigeria. Salt to taste, and then a red onion. Now, there are white and red sweet onions in Nigeria, but we are mostly into the red onion. So, let's get cooking. In goes the melanga white. All that it is, I peeled it, washed it, and then I chopped into little dice. As you know, it's quick and tasty food, right? That goes in. Remember melanga white. And for my fellow Ekpeye people, this is edebuji osa. Alright? And then in goes our burnt cow's skin. Just because I dice this smaller, it's gonna facilitate the cooking process. So it's gonna be a lot easier. That goes in. I'm telling you, this is a one-pot meal that you don't have to do so much. Here goes the snail. I already pre-washed it with lime. So now the texture is much stronger. There's no more sliminess. That goes in too. Now, like I told you, Nigerians cannot do without co-bouillon. So here goes my null cube. And here goes my pre-washed jumbo crayfish. Nigeria smokes. We smoke them. And it is so intense in flavor. It's slightly sweet. Hey, for the kicker of this soup, here we go. I'm telling you, you can't find it in any other tribe of Nigeria other than Ekpeye. It's a peasant soup, but believe me, you're gonna be amazed what this does. Look what I'm doing. No heads off. A lot of people say, why don't you take off the head? No. That's where the flavor is. Smoking this fish, this bony fish here. Normally we do this over open flame, but since I don't have an open flame, this does exactly the same work. Guess what? It's emitting, I wish you can smell this, it's emitting the best flavor that takes me straight to those memories when we couldn't afford luxury proteins. So this is how it happens. And you will enjoy this meal and you know that you are in Ekpeye land. No other tribe in Nigeria, guaranteed. No other tribe. And some of you might be thinking, oh, my God is about to get burned. No, ma'am. Or no, sir, it's not burning up. It is just, you want it like this. Because the charred flavor is what you need to flavor your soup. Here we go. You want to hear that sizzle. You want to hear that sizzle. Oh my goodness, I wish you can smell this. Can you smell it? Somebody say it's bony. Yes, it's bony. Every child born in Nigeria knows how to flake this fish while they are eating, not prior. Because if you debone it, if you flake it, your yield will become less. And don't forget, it's a peasant soup. So when it's peasant soup, you don't have that much money to lose that much sizes. Plus, you need all of that charredness to give you the flavor that you need. I've said it so many times. Here we go. You see that? Boom. So finally, here goes our blended pepper. Remember the scotch bonnet, the orange color scotch bonnet. All I did was blended it with some onions and some water. That's why the liquid in here is slightly small. So this makes up for the liquid that is required to make this soup. And as you know, we need salt. Now, at the beginning of this cooking, I don't add much for two reasons. As this soup reduces, you're gonna have concentrated flavors. So you don't want an over-salted soup. As you can see, every other ingredient has gone in. The only thing left is our palm oil and of course the oyster mushroom. So guess what? We're gonna cover it. It is on high heat. I'm bringing it to boil now. So now I'm gonna reduce to simmer and let it cook because you want that cow skin to be tender. That's really all that we need. And it's gonna take about, say, 10 to 15 minutes. Here we go. Remember the melanga white, cocoyam, AWG, whichever one you wanna call. That's what I blended in here. I cooked it in the same soup and now I just fish them out and then I blended. So that's gonna go in here. This is the thickening agent. That's the thickening agent right there. This soup is not meant to be too thick, nor is it meant to be too thin. So it's somewhere in between. And then in goes the palm oil. There's a reason I'm letting the palm oil go in first. Because I don't want nothing. I don't want that. I want the mushrooms to stay in their right size. I don't want to pieces them in here, you know, in the cause of stirring. So guess what? I'm gonna stir now. Now I'll tell you the secret to cocoyam thickening. If you cover this, it's gonna lose a little bit of the elasticity, which is good, you know, because I don't want it to be too thick, right? The palm oil brightens it. We don't do a lot of oil in my tribe as we do in my husband's tribe. This is even when. So now, in goes our oyster mushroom. You could use any type of mushroom you have. So I'm letting everything go in. And guess what? I'm gonna reduce this heat. I'm gonna cover. And this is just gonna simmer, trust me, for just 5 minutes. As you can see, our peasant melechi day is cooked and is ready to be savored. Now here we go. First is the bony fish. This is called bony fish. Look at the oyster. And then this is exactly the right consistency, not too thick. The good thing about this traditional authentic soups, everything has to be represented. You always want to make sure that whatever you have in this soup is represented in here. I know somebody might be wondering, oh, why is it all, it has some bone, be careful. If you are from Africa and you are from my tribe particularly, you won't be scared. Even a child knows how to eat this food. a perfect accompaniment since I'm from River State, and this is my journey to memory lane today. I'm gonna have it with Gary because Gary is what we eat more. Gary and cassava is what we eat more in River State. So now I'm gonna take this Gary. Like I said, I could mold this thing and fancify it. I'm not in the mood for that. I am very hungry to eat it exactly as we make it in River State. And then you come here and dunk. See, there's a reason these things are cut into bite size, especially the cow skin. So now the Gary for me is my transporter. And here I go. Listen, sometimes less is more. Authentic African cuisine. People know a lot of things about Nigeria. They know only the vices. What they don't know or have a clue is how versatile our recipes and our foods are. If you stick with me, I will take you on a culinary journey around the globe of Nigeria. Listen, I can talk you over and over. Stick with me. Nigeria has so much more to offer than you ever know. Ekpeye, you know, I think I have represented my tribe very well today. Thanks for tuning in, and please don't forget to check the next video. Ciao.